What's up, my dear friends and family? I'm Charmix, and today I'm going to be reacting to Courage the Cowardly Dog Exposed by Berlizzi, or as Berlizzi says, Berlizzi! Oh, I must seem insane. Anyway, I was looking at Berlizzi's recent videos, which he hasn't really uploaded in like 5 months. Well, he uploaded the other day, and I reacted to that video, and then I went back onto his like uploaded videos just to see if I'd missed any. And I found this one, Courage the Cowardly Dog Exposed, which was his like last video, and I just like skipped over it. So yeah, with that being said, today we're gonna ruin another part of our childhood. Whoopee! And yeah, with that being said, I hope you guys like this video. The original link's in the description. Make sure you go subscribe to Berlizzi. Make sure you go subscribe to Berlizzi if you haven't already. That link's also in the description. And without any further ado, let's begin. Aww.
Bro, I see him. I know how to play basketball.
What is a cockroach know about basketball? Mm-hmm.
He's jumping like crazy. Fucking stand still, you pussy.
Watch this.
I said this in the most recent reaction I did to Berlizzi. Where does this cockroach come from? Is there like an origin story or something? Because it just kind of randomly showed up, and I don't know where the cockroach came from.
This. Bro, in the corner. He's open. He's open.
Hey, I told you, bro.
Jumping. You got my ear.
Is that the person you're playing against?
I hear it. I see it. I'm playing. Damn.
You're garbage.
Oh my gosh, I can't. But through the incumbent of this patriarchal district about which I...
His Twitter at is King of Foreheads? What? That's kind of like a roast on yourself, isn't it?
Speak is truly a Christian... Christian, what? Kobe never lets me down. Kobe never lets me down.
Kobe's not even on the Lakers.
Who is that? That must be Roach B.
Roach B, did you just make somebody up?
That dog. Watch out, bro. Hey, bro. Can y'all do me a favor real quick? Bro.
One more. No, he really opened now. He really opened.
Swear!
He's gonna start yelling.
Cheating.
Get off me with that, bro. I'm playing the game myself.
You are a
bro.
If you're having troubles studying and there's a lot of noise around you, I recommend you just get some like earphones like this and just start playing some like classical music or something that will cut out the sound and allow you to focus on your schoolwork. That's just my two cents.
Bro, this is online.
Control your ass. Controller. With your ugly ass, man.
Bro. Bro.
Wet tenner.
Hey, bro. Can y'all quiet? Bro.
He's gonna yell.
What's that? And that dog, bro.
God, please. I need you to be quiet. I have 3 weeks left. I am so close to graduating, and I can't deal with this dog barking like that.
Chill out. What's wrong with you?
My file didn't save. My file didn't save.
You want to get him or should I?
Nah, I got this.
Go ahead. Get him. Roach him.
Hold up, bro.
Also, this is a side note, I should probably mention this. In the most recent video that Berlizzi did, which I reacted to, I asked how tall he was because, you know, he was around the height of the door frame, which are around 6'4"-ish. And people actually told me on Twitter that he's actually 6'5". Oh my goodness, Berlizzi, you are very tall. So how tall is your friend over here then? Because your friend over here, he's not that tall. Or he might just be average, because 6'5". That is huge. And I think the average male is around 5'9" to 5'10"-ish, I believe. So he might be average because Berlizzi is just like really tall. Either way, I just wanted to point that out. You know, that's crazy.
What do you think you're talking to like that?
Who?
I will slap the piss out your mouth.
Wait.
I was complimenting you.
Piss in his mouth.
I saw him drink it! Trust me!
You saw him drink pole. Let me see.
Hey, bro. Check it.
Pause, open your
bro,
mouth.
Bro, what are you doing? Bro! Whoa. Pause,
that's
bro!
Definitely
definitely the case of piss mouth. Mm. Why are you drinking piss?
What do you mean? I don't like
roaches, dog.
The dog is driving me crazy.
Dang, that's kind of funny, you know, because it's been about 4 months since you last exposed, brother. Where you been at? You know, the fans, they've been talking to...
This is four. That's four, yeah. We get five of them on each hand.
Someone needs to go
since
back
when
to school.
Is this for? I've never seen that ever.
Nah, it's been.
All right.
Don't you start with that again.
But the fans still need you. Regardless of what you're going through, the fans still
the
need
fans.
You.
The fans! It's always the fans! Are the fans in school? Are you in school?
This guy, have I gone to school? I've been to school once. Top of my class.
Mm-hmm. Nigga, what school you go to?
I went to Arthropod Estate.
Yep.
What?
Valedictorian, bitch.
Arthropod.
20,000 students. That's two families. Unheard of. Majored in plumbing. But life just kind of changes, you know?
Plumbing?
Shouldn't judge people like that, you know?
Look at Pumpkin. She agreed. I know you hear her agreeing. She out there loud. Yep. Exposed. You hear it? I know you hear it.
Oh, is, I just put this together. I'm so slow. Since this episode is on Courage the Cowardly Dog, does the dog outside barking have anything to do with this? Does it tie in somehow? Because I'm thinking that it does, based on what the episode is going to be about, I assume.
Do you hear it? Hello, do you hear it? Hello? Hello, are you deaf? Hello?
Hey!
Courage, you gotta roast him! What's good, y'all? Welcome back! It is your host with the roast, Barley Z! Yo!
I can't get over his intros. I can't get over them. Like, his yelling is crazy. I love it.
Oh, it's been a long time since I've seen y'all. Long time since you've seen me. The winner of the PS4, this nigga. Congratulations! Yo, you already know how this thing go. You spoken months ago. I've roasted finally. Are you ready? Let's get it!
We interrupt this program to...
No, I'm interrupting you.
Yo, it's been so long, but boy, hell no. Come on. I know it's like the first 2 seconds. But did y'all see him? This man looks like the little boy on them old Mad Magazine covers. All grown up, though. I know it's you, because...
Well, at least we know he's getting work.
Y'all both had them big-ass elephant ears. Can you hear me now? I know you can.
Wow, that's loud.
I bet if I flipped your head upside down, you'd look like a damn condom. Pause on that, though. I'm just saying, man. I heard a crimson chin, but who are you? Ding-a-ling chin? And I know you're probably like, damn, Berlisi, like, what did he do? Why are you going in on him like this? Man, it's not even about him, but just look at him. Be real with yourself. Do you trust him? You look like a liar. I wouldn't believe any news you told me. Special nowhere news? You have one piece of paper. How is this a special? How is this even playing on this table? I mean TV. How did they even get a signal here? What service provider? Look at the moon. Is that fungus? I hope you're poor.
It's a huge moon. If the moon was that close, like, the tides would be way too messed up.
Reporting on that? That looks dangerous! You know what? Yo, Clyde! Get this clown!
You righty, but I'm about to flame your shit. Big head ass, round head ass. Bitch, you look like Yao Ming off the rips.
Wait, who is this person? This is not Berlisi speaking. Who is this?
Stupid ass, bony built ass, people like he got more head, he got body built ass. Why you so scrawny, ugly ass? Bone, 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 built ass. You need to stop real quick, this nasty ass suit. You look funk, ugly ass. Bitch, you look like you wear that suit 7 days of the week. Stupid ass, gotta get it built ass. You hit that big ass head. You getting it for real, all the knowledge. Ugly ass, fat ass jaw, close your mouth. Don't want to see them little ass piranha catchers. Ugly ass, Venus trap ass mouth. You hit. Them shits look like it catch your ankle. Ugly ass. Got you now. Teeth ass.
All right. That's enough. Cease fire. Bring you courage,
and look, here come courage, little courage, bitch. Courage, look
at him. What the fuck is...
This is scarier than the monster.
That! Courage. You make me so sad. You canine lima bean. You know damn well them limbs ain't built to support that fat ass body. And then you get scared and act like this. What is that?
Courage! What's up with them chompers? Do you eat bricks? Did you swallow a bomb? Are you part hippo? How did your teeth get this bad? You only have 6 to take care of. What's going on? You have that one tooth that has a perfect cylinder hole in it. Do you smoke cigarettes?
Through the hole?
Do you smoke cigarettes and then ash them on that one tooth? Do you and this man get high before his program every day? Is that why you're so scared of that shadow? Scared over a shadow? That don't even sound right. What are you really afraid of? The dentist? The dentist probably afraid of you. You look like you got damn alien bacon shooting out your throat. What is that?
Alien
bacon? You're
about
to attack the dentist. You have rabies? You can't have rabies. Y'all live in the middle of nowhere. Nobody comes to visit y'all, but you still terrified all the time with your name Courage. That shit's so stupid to me, boy.
The cowardly dog! Abandoned as a pup.
Damn, that's kind of sad.
Abandoned as a pup. Abandoned as a
pup. I always found Courage to be really quite cute. Then I gotta find that with most animals.
Yup, yup, exactly. Feel that guilt. Feel that guilt. Is that your tooth in the trash can? Don't act like we don't see your diaper full of shit still. Nah, but this is pretty messed up. Like, come on, no dog deserves to be abandoned like this, bruh. But I know I'm not alone when I say I hate seeing those sad ass animal commercials. It's not that I don't care. But like, come on, I'm watching Family Feud right now. Then I get hit with some random ass guilt trip. Like, what if I'm allergic to pets, you know? But I never understood, like, how did they get these animals to look so damn sad? Do you know how?
How did they get them to look so sad? They probably sucked the animals in a cage. And then the owners from the other side of the cage are like waving a bone or something.
How hard it is to make a dog sad? Look at this dog! You can feel him gripping your soul right now! Why isn't the cameraman fixing the problem? Feed him! Love him! Don't vlog him! Can I get an update commercial? A damn before and after? Hold up. Am I going too far? Is this video gonna get demonetized? I can't have that! I guess I'm gonna have to let it slide! Wait, it don't feel right here, but I'm gonna let it slide still. I'm gonna let it slide.
You should have given me an ear rape warning there.
Abandoned as a pup, he was found by
Muriel,
who lives in the middle of nowhere.
Muriel.
No. Don't make this. No. I know it's coming, and please don't do it.
You a damn good woman. You were there when Courage needed you most. And even in the middle of nowhere, you continue to be a source of love, security, joy, and compassion for Courage. The family needs you. We all need you. But more than anything, your legs need you. They need you to start squatting, start stair climbing, start eating. Well, I don't know about start eating, Ben. You need...
Roasted. This did not go the way I was expecting it to go, because basically in every Berlizzi video, there's a character that he goes, I know you see blank with the curves and the thickness. That's kind of like an example, but he always kind of like sexualizes the character he's talking about. And I was really hoping that he wasn't going to do that with Muriel, because she's like 80.
You need to stop sitting down after you eat. Before that chair become a damn raft. Do me a favor. Give SpongeBob back his boots. Orville Redenbacher back his popcorn. And Colonel Sanders back his damn fried chicken. Clearly you've had enough. Put the bucket down. I'm on your ass. You can get it too.
He was found by Muriel, who lives in the middle of nowhere. With her
nowhere news.
But...
Eustace! I know the Bible says to respect your elders, and you look about old as the Lord himself, but I gotta roast you! You blind, strong chin bastard! Where do I begin? What detail should I hit you with first? I'm starting with your weak-ass outfit. Those overalls are stiff as hell. Did you use the whole starch bottle, bitch? Are those titanium overalls? They probably are, to support that old ass spinal cord. You know it's struggling to support that big ass head on that fragile ass neck. It's already bent a little bit. I see it sticking out of that big ass collar. What brand is that shirt? Pac-Man? Pac-Man?
Pac-Man. I get it. It looks like a Pac-Man.
Industries? You look like a damn big ass bird. You are an actual angry bird. Look at you. What the f*** is that chin, bro? Big ass speed bump hanging off your mouth. That chin is a lethal weapon. I bet when you...
Looks like one of Courage's teeth.
You shake your head no. You decapitate everyone around you. You murdering bitch. With that busted ass snapback. You have the nerve to wear it to the side like you cool. How are you and your wife blind? That's crazy to me. Can you even hear what kind of ear is that? This motherfucker is so tired of Muriel nagging, he grew his ear closed. What infection is that? What bacteria just turns your whole head into the letter J?
He could have been a boxer. You know how boxers get like cauliflower ear? There's a kid in high school that I knew. He was a pretty nice dude, but he was in the wrestling team, and his ears were like cauliflowered, and it just, oh my goodness, it looks friggin' messed up. And that's what happens when you get in too many like fights or you wrestle too much. I guess that's what could have happened here. I mean, just fully closed over.
Look, do me a favor. Put down that blank ass paper. You're not learning shit. Take that frying pan off your head and make an appointment for the dentist. I know your breath hot as shit, and you can take Courage Smoker Ass with you too. Oh, rickety ass house.
What creepy stuff happens in nowhere?
Hold up, bro. Do y'all see these monsters? Do y'all see them? I thought they lived in the middle of nowhere. And if they did, who's recording these people? How'd they get such close images?
Uh-oh.
Oh my gosh! Okay. Quickly! Let's analyze the facts. Number one, they live in the middle of nowhere. No neighbors, no civilization for miles. Fact number two.
Okay.
No disrespect this time, but Muriel and Eustace are both old as dirt, which means they probably never leave the house. Now, fact number three, we all know Courage is pussy. But fact number four, we also know Muriel is usually never afraid. It's as if she knows there isn't ever any real danger. Fact number five.
Where's he going with this?
They watch one channel every day, and it's the special Nowhere News, which feeds them images like this every day. Now, follow me on this. If Eustace and Muriel barely leave the house, that means Courage probably never leaves the house either. His whole existence is based around protecting these two old motherfuckers. But if he never has the chance to leave the house, and the only other life form he knows is through this TV, anybody coming to the door would be a monster. The mailman, monster. A potential friend.
I think the mailman's a monster to most dogs, because most dogs hate the mailman.
Monster! Now think about it. Eustace is literally reading this blank ass paper. He's way more blind than Muriel. And if he's listening to that TV every day, of course he's gonna be more terrified than her. But there ain't no danger. Ain't nobody there. They're in the middle of nowhere. Fuck the media. The only special thing about this news is that it's full of ding-a-ling lies.
Fake news!
You are fake news.
So if they all believe that there are real monsters, and all they have are literally each other.
Stupid dog! You made me look bad!
Why is Eustace doing this to Courage?
Stupid dog! You made me look bad!
You made me look bad? To who? The news guy?
I just noticed that hole on his tooth was on the other side than in the intro.
Courage is just trying to look out for you.
Look at this motherfucker leg.
He's trying to protect you. And you disrespect him like this. Are you serious? Look at him. That mask made that man go batshit crazy. And you think it's funny. You are sitting here torturing one of your only two friends. And you think it's funny. I can't let this shit slide. Eustace, you're the monster!
Oh, so Eustace is the monster. I was trying to put together what he was trying to get at, but there you go. Eustace is the monster.
Middle of nowhere, my ass! I got some for you, nigga!
Don't worry, Courage.
Is that him?
So bad, Eustace. That ass is-
Wait!
What? What now?
Just me. Relax. Relax.
You're better than this. Violence
is never the answer. No, he's being violent to that dog.
I get it.
He's the monster. I get it. But he's still attacking verbally. You can't take it physically.
Man, I don't care about none of that. I'm a physical nigga.
Okay. Real nigga.
Yep. Real nigga alert. Let me handle this.
Man, then go ahead. You handle it.
Stoney.
What a roach.
Stoney, what's good, boy? Yo, look.
How many people are in this? There are a lot of, like, people. More than normal, at least.
Hit the lab for me real quick, please. What? He got a gun this time. Just let's get in the booth. Thank you. All right, yep. One second.
Are they gonna make a diss track? Are they gonna make a diss track on him?
Oh yeah, you just had this coming. This for dogs worldwide. Courage, I got your back.
Yeah.
I think it is.
Eustace, you really so useless. You scared of homie Courage and you wonder why his mood switch. Calling him a stupid dog, looking like a frog. Beady ass glasses and then baggy ass overall. Swollen ass feet, are you Eustace?
I like this, I won't lie. Also, what is with the, in the background, you can hear like some lady moaning or something. If you just listen. Like, whose idea was to add that in here?
Noodle arms, my nigga, you eat food at all. I know you got your hat back, cause you going bald. That shit flat like a flapjack, you need to take it off. Even as a kid, I expected better from you. Mad at your wife and dog, but they protective of you. They the only friends you got, but you depressing and rude. You probably mad your dead brother more impressive than you.
Damn, son.
Fuck you and that ugly
ass. That was awesome.
Your house run down, you probably got rats. You broke as hell, you probably in debt. And your dog teeth bag, he smoked cigarettes. Killing them cause I'm drilling facts. Cinnamon with belligerent militant dealing. When I'm done, that's it? Alright, Stoney, kill this, bro.
Stoney and his bitch drop by so I can roast you, man. Your breast smell like shit, you got that fucking halitosis, man. I know you eat ass, you eat 10 times doses. Every time a nigga spit, I'm ripping down on your posters. Your busted ass over raws, looking like you pink bitches. Let you be jerking off your girl, got a stay kitten. Get your ankles broken up and dunked on by Blake Griffin. Me and Roach just stole your car and crashed it, but we ain't tripping.
That was awesome. That was awesome. However, you shouldn't expect less from Berlizzi because Berlizzi is actually in university or just graduated from university with an English art degree or something like that. So he should be able to, you know, rhyme quite well and should have quite a large vocabulary as he majored in, I believe, English or English arts or whatever.
Bruh, this nigga chin dead ass like a toilet seat.
Hey, thanks, Sonny. Appreciate you, bruh. Yep.
Bruh, you can really iron clothes on that motherfucker.
You alright now? Cool.
Wait, is it over? I think it is. Anyway, guys, I hope you liked this video. This is really funny, and the diss track was, it was really well done. I think Rice Gum has some competition. But nonetheless, I hope you guys liked this video, and if you did, make sure you give it a thumbs up, possibly share with a friend if you're new, and subscribe to join the family today, and also make sure you go subscribe to Berlizzi! That link's in the description. And yeah, with that being said, I'll see you guys next time. Boop!